What's up, Christ United Kids? I hope you're having an amazing day. Let's practice our verse for this week. Do you guys remember what it is? Matthew 5:14. You are the light of the world. You guys have it? You are the light of the world. Grab your Bibles and let's turn to Matthew 5. And we're going to start in verse 14 and see what else Jesus teaches us about what the light of the world means, all right? So it says, starting in verse 14, you are the light of the world. A city on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. All right? So, guys, this verse is so, so important. And I have some things I wanted to show you. So, this is a flashlight. All right? Now, if my room was all the way dark, let me see if I can turn this light off and if you'll be able to see it better. All right, so see my light? See how bright my light is? We are this light. When we ask Jesus to come into our hearts, we have him in us. Now, we don't want to hide that, do we? What happens if I take this light and I put this cup on top of it? Can you see any light? That's just like what Jesus was saying, was that we don't take a light and hide it. No, we don't. We want to uncover it and show it for everyone around to see us. And not just us. The end of the verse is so, so important. The end of the verse teaches us that when we have Jesus in our hearts, we're not supposed to hide that. We're not supposed to cover it up. We are supposed to let it shine. We should let Jesus shine all the time in what we say, in what we do. We need to be willing to tell everyone around us that we have Jesus in our hearts. And the reason why, when we do good things, is so that, not so that people will think, oh, she's so awesome. Look, she is just so happy. She loves so good. She is such an awesome person. No, that is exactly what we're not supposed to do. The end of the verse says, let your light shine before men so that the people around us can see God's good deeds and praise our Father in heaven. We are supposed to let our light shine to others so that they will know that it's Jesus. It's Jesus who helps us to love people. It's Jesus that helps us to be kind. It's Jesus who helps us to do good deeds. It is all because we have this light in our hearts. So today, don't hide the fact that Jesus is in you. Instead, shine his light to everyone around you. Tell them about the amazing things that he's done for you. Share with them how he has been so, so good to you. Tell them that he loves them too. And make sure that you are always, always, always giving him all glory and honor for the good that is in you. So let's pray for that right now. Dear Jesus, we thank you so much, God. We thank you that you live in each and every one of us. Today, Lord, help us not to hide our light, but to shine it to others so that they can see your good deeds, so that they can see you in each of us. God, help us to be a light in this dark, dark world, and help us to shine you to everyone we meet. And all God's children said, amen. All right, guys and girls, we're going to spend the rest of this week talking about ways that we can shine our light for others, ways that we can tell people how awesome God is. So it's going to be an awesome week, and I will see you tomorrow.